In this video, I'm going to be doing a complete iPage WordPress tutorial going over iPage and WordPress so you can begin in creating your WordPress site with iPage. I'll be running you through the steps in getting signed up with iPage, going over how to install WordPress on iPage, how to set up WordPress on iPage, activating the free Let's Encrypt SSL certificate, along with getting to know WordPress to make creating a WordPress site easy. I'll also be providing you with an iPage web hosting discount that you will get up to 75% off iPage hosting, plus a free domain name. Let's get started with the iPage WordPress tutorial. The first thing you want to do to get started with iPage is to click the link in the description below so you can be taken to iPage, and so you can take advantage of getting up to 75% off plus a free domain name. A little disclosure, the link is an affiliate link, meaning I receive a commission from iPage at no extra cost to you. Plus, you'll get an awesome iPage discount. Once you click the link in the description below, you'll be on the iPage homepage. Click the Get Started button. You'll now be on the domain page where you can choose a free domain name. You'll see over to the right under your cart section, the Save 75%. You'll see 3 years being selected. Click this and you can also choose a 2-year term or a 1-year term. You'll get the greatest discount with a 3-year term. You'll get iPage hosting for $199 a month. If you go with the 2-year term, you'll get hosting for $249 a month. If you choose the 1-year term, you'll get iPage web hosting for $299 a month. Choose a term you'd like to go with. For this tutorial, I'm going to choose the 12-month term. Now let's choose a free domain name. If you already have a domain name, you can just enter in the search field to continue with the domain you already have registered somewhere else. Once you type in a domain that you want for free, you'll be on a page saying if it is available or not. Under the domain section, you'll see Add Domain Privacy plus Protection being selected. This is an extra add-on that is completely optional. I highly recommend going with the domain privacy as this will protect your personal information from the public and can protect you from getting lots of spam and telemarketers reaching out to you via email and phone to sell you their services. When a domain name is registered, it is required, regardless of the company you go with, that your personal information be included in the public WHOIS database. By choosing Domain Privacy Plus Protection, instead of your information showing, it'll show iPage's information protecting you. Over to the right under the Your Cart section, you will now see the free domain name showing and the Domain Privacy Plus Protection if you decide to choose this. Click the Continue to Add-ons button. We will now be on the iPage add-ons page where you can select any add-ons you'd like to go with. All these add-ons are completely optional and you can even add these at a later time in the iPage dashboard. You get a cheaper price for them now if you get them when you initially buy your iPage web hosting. So just something to keep in mind. The first add-on is Website Backup and Restore. This can be a good add-on to have as it'll back up your site daily so that if you mess something up by accident or your site gets hacked or anything takes place, you can simply restore your site with a click of a button from the previous backup or a backup of your choosing. You'll notice this add-on is added to the cart by default. You can click the X button if you don't want to include this add-on. The next add-on is SiteLock. SiteLock protects your site from malicious attacks and hackers and from getting malware on your site. You'll receive daily malware scans, blacklist monitoring, which ensures your site doesn't get blacklisted by the search engines if your site does have a virus. It'll block automated bot attacks and includes automatic malware removal. When using WordPress to build your website, there are a lot of free security plugins that work just fine for protecting your site. So just something to keep in mind. SiteLock can be good as it'll protect your site, and if something does happen where it gets hacked, you won't be left trying to fix and find the malware. You'll notice this add-on is added by default. You can click the X button and remove this add-on if you don't want it. The next add-on is Google Workspace. With this add-on, you'll get access to an email address ending in the domain name that you went with. Along with that, you'll also get access to their storage, calendars, video meetings, and more business solutions. Google Workspace runs as low as $6 a month. Your iPage hosting account will come with a free email address ending in your domain name, so unless you really want the Google Workspace features, I don't recommend this add-on. Next, click the Continue to Billing button over on the right. You'll now be on the Billing and Payment Information page. You want to enter your billing information and then enter your payment information. You can also make a payment via PayPal if you'd prefer. Click the Buy Now button. You've now successfully purchased iPage web hosting. iPage will now email you your receipt along with login details so you can log into the iPage dashboard and you can continue in creating your site. Once logged into iPage, you'll be on this page here. You'll see the domain name you registered for free. Click Manage and you'll be taken to the iPage summary page. We now want to install WordPress on iPage. You'll see WordPress in the side menu. Click this. You now want to click the Get Started button. You'll now be on the Hosting Options page. Click the Use Existing button to use the iPage web hosting plan you purchased. Next, you want to input a site title name for your website. You now want to input an email address and the username and password used when logging into your iPage account. Click the Install WordPress button. You'll now be on the WordPress page where you can view statistics and manage your site and plan. You'll see to the right the settings area. The site name will say queued right when you get to this page, and then we'll switch to running shortly after. Once the WordPress install is complete, it'll say the title of your site. Before we move on and click Manage Site, we want to activate the free Let's Encrypt SSL certificate so your site is secure. To do this, click Summary in the side menu. You'll see under Domain Settings the free Let's Encrypt SSL certificate. You want to toggle this to On. You also want to toggle the Enforce SSL to On as well. Once both of these are toggled to On, the SSL certificate is now activated and running for your WordPress site. Next, click the WordPress link in the side menu. Next, click Manage Site. You'll now be taken to the WordPress login page. You can also get to the WordPress login page for your site by typing in your domain name with a /wp-admin in the top search engine address bar, like seen here. I would bookmark this URL as this is the easiest way to log in to WordPress to begin in creating your site. Once you input your login information, you'll be in the WordPress dashboard. Let's get to know WordPress a bit. You'll see the Settings tab in the left menu. Hover over this and click General. You can change your site title and tagline of your site here. Also, your site has a Coming Soon page showing to site visitors. Scroll down to the bottom of this page, you'll see the Mojo Coming Soon Enable that is set to On. To launch your WordPress site, change this to Off and click Save Changes. Next, under Settings, click on Permalinks. You'll see it is set to Date and Name. You want this to be changed to post name. Save your changes below. This is the proper URL structure that you want, especially for SEO on any post that you publish. For example, if someone comes to a post that you've written, it'll say your domain name with the date in the post name after the date, like seen here. You want it to show your domain name and then the post name like this. To view your site and what it looks like, hover over your site title name in the top left. You'll see Visit Site. Click this and it'll take you to your homepage. You'll see there's nothing to it now. You want to choose a theme so you can begin in creating your site. To pick out a theme for your site, in the far left menu, you will see tabs. Find the Appearance tab and hover over it. Click Themes, as this is where you can pick out a theme for your site. Next, click WordPress.org themes at the top. You'll now see popular WordPress themes. If you click Latest, it'll showcase the latest WordPress themes that you can choose from. There are thousands of themes you can choose from. Once you find a theme, hover over it and click the Install button. Once it is done installing, click the Activate button. This is now the WordPress theme for your site. If you want to browse premium WordPress themes, you can click the Premium button and you can browse premium themes from the Mojo Marketplace. If you click Demo, you can view what the theme looks like. Let's continue in getting to know WordPress. On the far left, you will see Post. Post is where you can add new posts. Pages is where you can add new pages. The Media tab is where you can upload images to your site, or where your images will show that you have already uploaded to your site. Comments is where you can view comments people leave on your blog. Hover over the Plugins tab in the left menu. Click Add New. This is where you can add new plugins for your site. Pretty much any feature or customization you would want, more than likely there's a plugin to do that. Something I highly recommend when building your WordPress site is a plugin called Elementor. Elementor is a drag and drop editor page builder for WordPress. Elementor is the number one WordPress page builder, and over 10 million websites have been built with Elementor. This plugin can save you a ton of time and lots of headaches figuring out how to make specific customizations. This plugin has a free version and a paid version. I provide a link in the description below so you can check out Elementor. If you want to activate the plugin for your WordPress site, find the Plugins tab over to the left and click Add New. Type in Elementor in the search field. You'll see the Elementor plugin. Click the Install Now button and click Activate to activate the plugin. Another great site if you need help with designing your customizations in WordPress is Fiverr. Fiverr is a great place to get tasks done at a cheap and competitive price. It is helpful if you need a logo, website changes, or something else done. I provide the link in the description below. That is my iPage WordPress tutorial for beginners video. Thanks for watching. Give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more hosting video tutorials. Leave us a comment. We love hearing from you.